Hi everyone, this is Pradeep Vibhuti. So now we'll see Ward-Leonard test, that is speed control of motor, DC motor, using generator and induction motor. Here should note that induction motor is mechanically coupled to the generator, DC generator, and we should also note that generator armature supply is not being given, and it will generate using, since field is excited and it is driven by, its rotor is driven by induction motor, so EMF is generated in the generator and that is brought to the switch, and through switch it goes to the armature of the motor, and which is in turn connected to the brake drum. In this experiment we are not using any mechanical load on motor. Here we are exciting the motor and armature supply is given from the generator output. So we'll go through the connection once. So this is the experimental setup, wherein you can see the three phase supply is given to the auto transformer, three phase auto transformer input, and the output of the auto transformer is brought to the RYB connection of the induction motor. Here induction motor is run at near to 1500 rpm. Since it is induction motor, it will never come into synchronization, synchronous speed, so it will run below synchronous speed, that is 1500. And you should also note that there is no armature supply given to the generator armature. So voltage will be generated using field excitation and prime mover. And the output of the generator is given here. So positive comes here and negative comes here. Voltmeter is kept across the generator output, and once the switch is applied, the output will go to the motor setup. So here in this panel number 7, we only have induction motor and DC generator, and DC generator output is going through these two blue wires through switch, and it is going to the armature input. So you can see there armature input is given from the generator output. So here connection is simple. Armature supply is not given from the panel, since armature supply is brought from the generator output, and field excitation is given through motor field, that is from motor field to ammeter, ammeter to rheostat, and rheostat back to the field, and from field back to the field supply. So we'll conduct the experiment. Here we note that our field circuit consists of ammeter, rheostat, and field winding. All three are in series, and we should note that for generator, rheostat position should be in cut-in position. So we'll start the experiment by switching on the main supply, and we'll start the auto transformer to excite the induction motor from 0 volts to 400 volts. So we are giving, this is the induction generator supply, induction motor supply, which is near to, and we'll excite it near to 400 volts, and we can see that it is less than 1500 rpm, and now we'll excite the generator field supply. So we can see the generated voltage across the generator is around 162 volts, and now we'll switch on the switch such that the generated DC voltage supply will be given to the motor armature, and so I'm switching it on and motor starts to rotate in reverse direction. So motor is rotating in reverse direction. To motor to rotate in forward direction, you have to change either these two terminals, or you have to interchange the supply at the armature supply. So now we will control the speed of motor using rheostat of generator. That is, excitation of generator is being excited and voltage will be increased. Since voltage of generator is increased, the speed of the motor will be increased. So for different set of voltages, that is 170, the speed is noted down. So speed, you can see here it is 1136 for 170 volts, and for 180 volts it is 1200 RPM. So as we go on increase the voltage of the generator, the speed of the motor is increasing. So we'll take around 5 to 6 readings and we plot the graph for reverse direction. The similar procedure is done for after taking the readings, we bring back the rheostat to initial position and we switch off the switch which is connected to the motor, and we reduce the auto transformer. So before that, we have to de-excite the generator field, and we reduce the auto transformer.